getting close, cause I'm about to let you know. Stick to your budget, you know your pace. Invested in the market, you know what you can make. Keep your dough safe, that's only if you serious about these money issues.
Do you wanna know how to make your money grow? Do you wanna know? Do you wanna know?
New age money makers, you know it's in you. Make this paper paper, you know what it feeds you.
Make your money grow, make your money grow.
It's for the future, it's that simple.
And thank you so much for joining me once again. In the last lesson, we looked at doing a feasibility study for our business idea before we even start planning for the business itself. And we also learned that we need to look around in our community for business ideas that we can offer for the people's needs and wants.
For sure, Mompo, how are you doing? We need to realize now that I can start an extra lessons business for teaching the learners at my sister's school subjects like maths and accountancy, which are two of my strengths.
That's great, Mandla. Now, in today's lesson, we are going to be taking a close-up look at doing a feasibility study. Do you remember what a feasibility study is, Mandla?
Yeah, a feasibility study is something you do before you start a business, just to find out if your business will be successful or not.
Exactly. The feasibility study determines whether your business idea is going to work. So first, you'll need a business idea. The next step was to do a SWOT analysis. We will be learning about this later. We then need a marketing plan or strategy.
Yes, we need to take a look at our target market. Those are the people we'll be selling our product or our service to.
That's right. Don't forget that marketing is about more than just advertising. It's about how we present our product. It's about our customer service, packaging, pricing, and so on.
You also spoke about the need to choose a form of ownership, didn't you?
Well remembered, Mindler. You need to decide if you're going to manage the business on your own or whether you want to ask other people to share the ownership with you.
Well, I suppose if I did do my business with a friend, it would make things easier. But that also means we have to share profits.
Well, keep thinking about it, Mindler. You'll also need to decide whether or not you're going to employ other people.
Well, maybe in the future, if my business is doing really well, but not to begin with.
Finally, you need to identify whether there are any legal requirements or responsibilities and decide whether you're going to take out insurance. For example, if you're going to be selling food, there are a number of laws that you need to follow. The area where you are making your food needs to be clean and hygienic.
Yeah, I think I might have to speak to the principal just to find out if it's okay. I guess that's also a kind of responsibility, right?
Good thinking. We can then calculate the amount of capital or money we will need to start our business.
But Mompo, what if I'm broke? I mean, I don't have a cent in my pocket.
Then you would need to think about borrowing the capital, Mandla. You'd also need to think about how much money you'd need for things like the equipment or raw materials you'd need to start your business. If you were selling cakes, then you'd work out how much you'd need to buy flour and eggs and things like that to bake your first cake.
Well, I'll need money to buy textbooks and also photocopy notes for my customers and also buy stationery, those kind of things.
Exactly. Now, once we have the money we need to start our business, we need to mind our money. We have to plan how we will spend this money so that we can use it in the best and wisest way.
Like, it would be a better idea to borrow the textbooks in the beginning and buy my own later.
That kind of thing, yes. Once all of this research has been done, we need to make a very important decision. Do we decide to abandon our idea because it is not feasible? Do we decide to redo our calculations? Or do we decide our business idea is feasible and we should start to proceed with it?
Hey, that's a lot to think about, Mompo.
This flowchart is actually very useful and will make your preparations easier. Just keep it handy and you can tick it off each block as you complete it. Once you have decided to go ahead with the business, it is time to write up a business plan.
Hey, that's what I want to do. I need to start working on the business plan side of things. So let's get this party rolling.
Once you have finished your studies and you get this far with the business idea, you need to be very careful. If you're going to invest a lot of savings in your idea, then you must get good legal, business, and financial advice before you make your final commitment to this particular idea.
All right. But Mambo, tell me, once I'm satisfied that this is definitely the right business idea for me, what do I do?
Just wait a moment, Mandla. Let me tell you a very sad story first. In Durban, a few years ago, they did a study on new businesses and they discovered that 80% of new business in the Durban area failed. 80%.
Yo, that's scary. Mampo, why do you think so many businesses failed?
The reasons the study gave were over-eagerness, inexperience, not enough research, bad planning, and people not using professional services.
I'll definitely take a lot of care and do my planning properly. But what if my business is a success and is doing really well after a few years? What do I do if I want to start a proper company?
To take your business to the next level, you would need to do the following. First of all, you would need to get legal, business, and financial advice.
Well, Mampo, I'd come and ask you for financial advice. I mean, you're a genius.
Oh, thank you, Mandla. Next, you'd need to obtain a business license and then register the business with the necessary authorities.
Hey, that sounds hectic. How am I supposed to know all those things?
Remember, if you'd ask for the right advice, then you'd already know exactly what to do.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Next, you'd need to get the capital you need for your business. We will be looking more closely at this later. Mandla, how would you want your business to expand?
Well, I was thinking maybe I could buy some offices and employ teachers and university students to do the teaching. In that way, it would be a success. And hey, we could also have our own classrooms and stuff.
So you'd need business premises where you could run your business from. You'd also need to buy computers, furniture, blackboards, and all those kinds of things.
Hey man, you're really smart. I didn't even think about furniture.
It's not me, Mandla. It's just the business plan. Next, like you'd already said, you'd not be able to run the business on your own, so you'd need to employ other people to assist you.
I'd employ only good teachers or students who really knew their work. I mean, it would be so much fun.
Yeah, and you'd also need to buy all the stationery, the pens and paper and things that would get used up.
Well, hey, I just remembered, hey, we cannot forget advertising. I mean, I can't get anywhere without advertising.
That's true, Mandla. It's very important to let all your potential customers know that your new offices are opening. So you'll need to activate your sales campaign. But that's not all, Mandla. One of the most important aspects of setting up a new business is setting goals and targets for business. It's just like if you don't set goals in your life, you are unlikely to achieve very much.
For sure, Mampo. My goal is for my business to be a real success.
That's a good target, Mandla. Next, we'll need to make all the different areas in the business and make sure that everyone is working towards the same goals that you have set.
What we need is team spirit, with everyone working towards the same goal, like a soccer team.
The last one is very important, and many people forget about it. It is important to keep accurate records and analyze the financial results of your business in order to make the best management decisions for the future.
Hey, cool, man. But I'm not sure if I've got it 100%. Do you think we can do a quick revision?
Of course, Mandla, I've got an idea. Let's try this feasibility study with another type of business. I have a friend called Peter, and he also has a business idea. He'd like to provide a garden cleaning service over the weekends and after school.
Oh, so he's another young entrepreneur just like me.
Exactly. Let's take a look at his feasibility study. Why don't you list the different steps from the flow chart and I'll fill in the details.
All right, firstly, he needs his business idea.
Peter will cut grass, clear weeds, sweep up leaves, and clear garden refuse.
And then he also needs to take a look at the SWOT analysis and his marketing plan.
That's right. He needs to do research and find out who would want to use his service and be prepared to pay for his service.
Yeah, he needs to decide on ownership as well.
Peter needs to look at that very carefully. Should he go into business with a friend or should he do it alone?
Yeah, he needs to decide if he's going to employ anyone in his business.
Does he want to employ people? How much would he have to pay them? Can he do all the work himself? The business might be too small in the beginning, and it would be better not to employ staff and do all the work himself. What's next, Mandla?
What about legal responsibilities and insurance?
Yes, well, what about them? Peter would need to find out if there are any laws he needs to obey or whether he should take out any insurance.
Cool. Next, he needs to decide how much capital he needs.
This is a very important decision, but don't worry, we will be learning how to do this properly in a later lesson. What's next, Mandla?
Costing. What's that again?
That's how much the service will cost Peter and how much he will be able to charge customers. And lastly?
Lastly is financial planning.
Financial planning is very important and must be done carefully and accurately. Now, once Peter has gone through the feasibility study and completed every step, he will need to make some very important decisions. Does it look like his business idea is a potential business opportunity? Should Peter redo his feasibility study because it does look like a good business opportunity? but there are areas that need to be looked at more carefully. Or should Peter just abandon the idea and look for another completely different idea?
So many questions, Mampo. I don't know, Joe. Okay, give me time to think about it and I'll catch up with you on the next lesson. Ne? Ciao.
I want all our viewers, not some, but all of our viewers to think of a business idea. Then draw up a feasibility study to find out if your business idea has the potential of becoming a great business opportunity.